We often work with MATLAB functions that make use of a second function, which must be passed as input to the first. For example, in order to locate a local minimum value of a polynomial, we can use the function fminsearch. But when we call fminsearch, we also need to include another function, one that will compute the values of the polynomial we are trying to minimize. So, how do we pass one MATLAB function as input to another? We have two options available to us. Let's say that our input function can be expressed on a single line, like our polynomial. In this case, we'll create an anonymous function. Anonymous functions provide a means to define a MATLAB function in a compact manner, which can then be passed as input. Let's see how. Our anonymous function will accept a single input argument that we'll call x. Inputs are placed in parentheses following the at symbol. Anonymous functions return a single output, which is defined after the inputs. Our output will be computed according to the polynomial formula. When this command is entered, the result is a variable of a new type called a function handle. We've named ours f. The function handle provides a way to pass the anonymous function as input to fminsearch, which uses the input function to compute polynomial values. Note that we can also use the function handle variable to call our anonymous function by providing an input argument. But what if our input function is too complex to express in a single line? In this case, we have a second option available for passing a function as input. After writing our input function, we'll create a handle to myFun directly by placing the at symbol before the function name. We can then pass the function handle as input, as before. The same technique can be used to create a handle to any existing MATLAB function before passing it as input. And that's it. So, the next time you want to pass one function as input to another, remember to use a handle.